This video is brought to you by IXL, used by millions of students worldwide to get ahead in math, English, and more.
We can solve a system of equations by graphing. Let's find out how. First, let's graph a line. This line is the graph of the equation y equals 3x. Note also that every point on the line is a solution to y equals 3x. The point 1, 3, the point 2, 6, the point negative 3, negative 9, they are all on the line and they are all solutions to the equation of the line. Remember also, in order to be a solution to a system of equations, a point has to be a solution to every equation. Let's add the graph of the line y equals x plus 4. Every point on this line is a solution to y equals x plus 4. But there is one point on both lines, 2, 6. This is the point where the lines intersect, the only point that is a solution to both equations. So 2, 6 is the solution to the system of equations, y equals 3x and y equals x plus 4. That's right, to solve a system of equations by graphing, all we have to do is find where the graphs intersect. Let's try a few examples. Solve this system of equations by graphing. Y equals 1 half x plus 4, and y equals 3 halves x plus 2. The first equation is y equals 1 half x plus 4. Well, the y-intercept is 4, so let's plot the point 0, 4. The slope is 1 half, so move up 1 and to the right 2 to find another point on the line. Draw a line connecting them, and we have our first line. Y equals 3 halves x plus 2 is also in the slope-intercept form. The y-intercept is 2, so we plot the point 0, 2. The slope is 3 halves, so let's move up 3 and to the right 2 to find another point on the line and draw a line connecting them. Now, where do these lines intersect? The lines intersect at 2, 5. So the solution to the system of equations is 2, 5. Let's try another. Solve this system of equations by graphing. Y equals 1 fifth x plus 5, and y equals 6. The first equation is y equals 1 fifth x plus 5. We can plot this just like the previous lines. The y-intercept is 5, so plot the point 0, 5. The slope is 1 fifth, so move up 1 and to the right 5 to plot another point on the line. Draw a line connecting them. The second equation is y equals 6. And this equation doesn't depend on x at all. The equation tells you that every y value is 6. So let's plot some points that have a y value of 6, like 0, 6, and 1, 6, and then draw a line connecting them, and it's a horizontal line. Now let's find where the lines intersect. They intersect at 5, 6. So the solution to the system of equations is 5, 6. Awesome! One more. Solve this system of equations by graphing. X plus y equals 7, and x minus 2y equals negative 8. The first equation is x plus y equals 7, and this time it's not in slope-intercept form. It's in standard form. But don't worry, we can do this. We can graph a line in standard form by finding the x-intercept and the y-intercept. The x-intercept is on the x-axis where y equals 0. If you plug y equals 0 into the equation, you will find that x equals 7. So one point on the graph is 7, 0. Let's plot that. The y-intercept is on the y-axis where x equals 0. If you plug x equals 0 into the equation, you'll find that y equals 7. Another point on the line is 0, 7. Let's plot 0, 7 and draw the line connecting them. One down. The second equation is x minus 2y equals negative 8, also in standard form. Again, let's graph it by finding the x-intercept and the y-intercept. The x-intercept is on the x-axis where y equals 0. Plugging y equals 0 into the equation, we get x minus 2 times 0 equals negative 8. Since 2 times 0 is 0, we get x equals negative 8. So one point on the graph is negative 8, 0. The y-intercept is on the y-axis, where x equals 0. Plugging x equals 0 into the equation, we get negative 2y equals negative 8. Dividing each side by negative 2, we have y equals 4. Another point on the graph is 0, 4. We can plot both points and draw a line connecting them, and the lines intersect at 2, 5. So the solution to the system of equations is 2, 5. The solution to a system of equations is where their graphs intersect. So if we can plot it, we can solve it.
Head over to iXL.com to check out this video and thousands more in math and language arts.